Hi, everyone. It's Emma Henderson and Jenson
Strock
here. Okay, so we just got inside the Trump rally maybe 15 minutes ago. So they started letting people in early, and we are already seeing a large amount of crowd. So if Jenson wants to flip around the screen, we can show you how many people are already here. So you can see, I mean, if you've been to a walleye game, then you're kind of familiar with the layout here. We're standing on where the ice would be right now, and there's quite a few people right now. So the podium is right past this large group of people, right under the large American flag. You can see the Keep America Great logos and stuff where you would normally see kind of the walleye power play things and things like that. So quite a few people already in here. The line outside was significantly long already when we saw it. So I can only imagine people are continuing to stream in. It seems like some of the chairs that were empty when we got here are now filled. So there's definitely more people coming in. And remember, this speech doesn't actually start until 7 p.m. So we still have a significant amount of time until he's actually going to be here. And you know, VP Pence will also be here. And then we also found out that the governor is going to be here.
Yes.
So there are going to be quite a few people here for this rally. I mean, when you think about it, this is the first campaign event that he is hosting in 2020, and he's in Toledo. So they're bringing out a lot of people. It's a big event. I mean, about 8,000 people fit in here.
Yeah.
And based off of how many people we've seen outside, I don't think it's too much to say this will probably be filled up.
Oh, no, absolutely. And people have been waiting since yesterday, like 12:30, lining up. And so that's just incredible to me. And one thing I will say is that between the protesters and between the Trump supporters, there has been nothing but just positive energy. I've seen a lot of positive interactions. There's been just a lot of excitement because I think no matter where you're at in the political spectrum, it's an exciting thing to have a sitting president here in Toledo. So that's something I think that's a testament to our city especially, is just the positivity that we've seen throughout all of this.
Absolutely. And we've been seeing a lot of law enforcement as well. So we have seen quite a few TPD officers. We've seen Secret Service. Obviously, Toledo Fire is also heavily involved. If you come over to this area, you will see a very large increased police presence. We did talk to the city. We found out it's about $30,000 in overtime that they are predicting for the cost. But obviously, the number one priority is to keep everyone here safe. And when you have such a large number of people in the area, that's going to take a lot of manpower. So that's what we're dealing with right now. So again, this is hours. This, what you're seeing is hours before the president even arrives. So we are going to be checking in with you throughout the day, but this is literally our first glimpse.
Yes.
Again, we've only been in here for about 15 minutes. If you are going to be in here or you are in here, we would love to hear things in the comments. If you are out protesting, we would also love to hear from you. I know a lot of the main protests really kick off at 5 p.m., so they still have a little while until we probably see those ramp up. But, you know, knowing Toledo, this is a very active community no matter what side of the political spectrum you are on. So we anticipate both seeing and hearing from quite a few of you guys.
I have a couple digital notes.
Absolutely.
If you want to be watching the rally, we're going to have that. Make sure you download our free WTOL 11 News app. We'll be streaming that. We'll also be streaming it on Facebook. So just be aware. We will have all of that content for you. Also, if you do plan on coming down here and you're not here yet, there is a list of items that you cannot bring in. So that's also on our website and our news app. So check that out before you head in. I would hate for you to have to leave stuff at the door. But it's very exciting stuff going on here. Make sure, again, you check out our news app for all of the Trump stories that you want to see. We have all of that. We'll be live in all of our newscasts. Got Emma here, of course.
So we'll break it down a little bit. So I will be inside along with Andrew Kinsey, and then we will also have, we have people outside, one with the protesters and one with the supporters. So we will make sure to have all angles covered for you, talking to as many people as we possibly can to really get the feeling for how Toledo is reacting, having President Trump here.
Yeah. And I think this is great. These Facebook Lives are a fun opportunity to be able to show you what we're seeing as we do it. It's all unscripted, just raw footage of what we are seeing. And we'll be continuing to do these throughout the night, too, so that you can see just what's going on if you can't make it out here tonight.
Right. Because, I mean, this is all new to us. I mean, we live in Toledo, too, so this is not our normal coverage. This is not a normal story that we cover every day. And so we do have a full team on it, and we're going to make sure that We do our best to keep you informed of everything. If you have any questions, please feel free to drop them below. I've got to go do an interview, but I'm going to give this off to Jenson.
All right, well, I'm going to wrap it up here anyway. Thank you so much for watching. Keep checking back again. Download our free WTL 11 News app. We'll be streaming the rally. That's supposed to kick off at 7. And we'll be keeping you updated on if any time changes happen. We don't know how long the speech will last. But, Brittany, yeah, it should start at 7 p.m., which you can, again, watch through our free WTL 11 News app. Thank you so much for watching.